our strange average sun. Hey, stargazers, Trace Dominguez, science communicator and astronomy enthusiast here. Our sun is always up there, consistently shining its warmth and energy onto our planet every day of the year for billions of years now. But even though it seems as basic as a Tuesday iced coffee, our sun is actually kind of a weirdo, like in the best way. For example, it's not actually yellow or white. If you look at the spectra coming off the sun, it's about 5,800 Kelvin, or greenish blue. We just think of it as white or yellow because of how our eyes process light and the atmosphere scatters it. Honestly, the sun? Not even that bright. I mean, for a star. When you're out at night, all the stars you can see are brighter than our sun. From Alpha Centauri, our sun would be about as bright as Rigel in Orion appears from Earth. But Alpha C is only 4 light years away, Rigel is 864 light years away, and that star is 47,000 times brighter than our sun. Not to say the sun isn't powerful. Right now, the sun is at a period of very low activity. We're in a solar minimum. But during the solar maximum, the sun is nutso, emitting stronger magnetic fields, creating solar storms, space weather, and of course, producing powerful explosions of material like solar flares and coronal mass ejections, which can cause blackouts on Earth's poles and pose a danger to astronauts and satellites in space. It's all pretty incredible. And this is why we keep a close eye on our sun and track the solar cycle. We do this by counting the number of sunspots on the sun's surface. Fewer sunspots, less solar activity. More sunspots, more activity. Sunspots aren't actually dark. They just appear darker than the surrounding solar atmosphere. By counting the number of sunspots, astronomers were able to recognize a pattern in solar activity that coincided with lots of other atmospheric and solar phenomena, like aurora, which are strongest during solar maximums. So cool. We're at the end of the 24th solar cycle since we started keeping track in the mid-1700s. We've already spotted the start of cycle 25, and hopefully it will make for some amazing astronomy from our average amazing star. Keep looking up.